food. You guys eat the stuff? Yeah, yeah, there you go. I was doing this the other night. I was standing in front of the fridge trying to decide what to have for dinner, and I'm having fun doing it. You ever do that? And you're just like, ooh. The limitless possibilities. The permutations. The combinations. I'm in the fridge and I'm just like, ooh yeah, what am I gonna have tonight? Ooh yeah. I'm elbow deep in this fridge, you know. What you got back here, baby girl? Peanut butter and pickles, maybe. What am I gonna have tonight? Oh, I could eat you sardines, but I'm not gonna. I'm gonna save you for later. Actually, what you doing in the fridge, sardines? You in a can. You belong in a cabinet, girl. Shit. Oh, why'd I put you in the freezer then? You know, you gotta go. We all do this, right? Maybe not in precisely that way, but I think we've all had those thoughts. And it struck me, that's kind of an entitled question, right? What am I going to have tonight? That's sort of an entitled way to put that. Not like, oh, I hope there's something good, but like, what's it going to be? Who's going in here, you know? Like, there haven't been a whole lot of people who've lived in societies throughout history who could ask themselves that, what am I going to have tonight? Right? Like, say you've been born a poor Ukrainian child during the arms race. I don't think you'd very often find yourself being like, what am I going to have tonight? Oh, that's right. Sawdust again. You know, you'd never... you wouldn't do that. But we have so much food now, we just fuck with it. We play games with it, make reality shows about it. We tell stories with it. Like for the kid, perfect example for the kids, Ants on a Log. Do you guys remember Ants on a Log? Yeah. Right, there's a whole narrative to it. You get the celery out, you go cream cheese or peanut butter. That's fucking choose your own adventure right there. Put the raisins on top. Ants on a Log, yeah! Mm. Good shit. Good shit. Good shit. What we forget, though, is that our prehistoric ancestors would have eaten fucking ants on a log, right? Like, they would have loved that. They would have done a double take, like, oh, yeah, I'm going to eat tonight, not telling the others. You know? They would have eaten every last ant, and when they were done, they would have eaten the fucking log. That's what they would have done. But now we've got so much food, we can write off whole categories. No, I don't eat that. Hey, bro, what's in that? Because you know I don't eat wheat. The fuck did you say? You know, wheat. The crop that's allowed humanity to flourish since the birth of civilization in the Fertile Crescent? Yeah, I don't eat that. It's cool if you eat it. Just try not to breathe around me afterwards, okay? No, I don't have celiac disease. I just don't like the way it makes me poop, okay? I don't eat it. Meanwhile, our little Ukrainian friend would have been like, I have heard that in America, they have thing called poop. Poop, what is this poop? They're having so much food, some of it is coming out other side. Other side? You mean that's not just for hiding grandfather's fillings? Not in America.